say it was warm. No warning at all. Where was the label that said it was warm?
Where's the fire watch? There was supposed to be a fire watch.
Supposed to be a fire watch. Yeah, you guys running with your bucket of water.
That's going to lead in nicely to safety chat.
We'll get the next one. Video. How about that?
Right. Yeah. Good morning for those of you that are joining us on, let's see, this is what's that thing called? Facebook Live and YouTube later on. Introduce these two guys to you here a little bit. On your right out there is Kressel from Maker Size. Say good morning. And now on your right out there is Doug Fox from Doug Fox. He's a, what do you call yourself, an electrical engineer? That you are you doing, going to stay in your job and go back to school for your...
I've been doing it for a year now. School part.
That's sick. Yeah.
I
was only looking to get out of school when I was in school, and he's going back for his systems engineer, which I, he had to tell me what it was. But it means it's an engineer that puts together whole systems, not just electrical stuff. And let me show you first what we've been doing in the boat, and we'll come back and talk to those guys in a bit. And there's Betsy.
I'm red in here. Are you sure you're on?
I don't know. Is it not? Yeah, I'm on. I got people chiming in there.
Okay.
All right, it's working.
It's not working there.
It's not?
So I don't know what you're on.
No, no. Red's right.
No, red is not right.
Red is not right. I'm using it. Red's right. It's the green one over here that says you got somebody hooked up. That's our Wi-Fi Netgear broadcaster that we use for pumping the signal through here. Where did Bob go? Is he out on the patio?
I don't know.
All right, we'll come back around and find Bob. Man, it was hot yesterday. It's actually cool this morning, but the sun's out, so it's going to change. Let me show you what we got done yesterday. In here. And let's see, I'll try and do it from up on deck. Because Wi-Fi doesn't go down to the hull so well. Oh, look at that. Yeah, those are cleaned up, moved the tiles back, cleaned up all the crap that was underneath them. Did rain last night. I got a little bit of water down in there. And you can see we've been painting inside of that fuel tank and that keel. That was a lot of cleanup work to be done. Now, we're going to have to take a spider's web out this morning going down the ladder here. Sorry, dude. Hey, wake up. It's time to get up. You got it. Yeah, come on. You got it. I'm not something to eat. There you go. Drop away. Well, that was a nice escape. Okay. This is so funny. That right there looks like wood. It's actually water. It just has so much crud in it that stuff lays on its surface. And here's the tanks. Oh, we didn't get much water in here. We had to dry them out and everything. And they're painted now. So down inside is fuel sealing paint. So it's we'll take the diesel and it will help keep the diesel from getting through the welds into where it shouldn't be or where we really don't want it. And it'll also give us a nice white base down there. For those of you that have seen our tiles in, but not seen our tiles out, this is what it looked like when we pulled the tiles back from all the wood shavings and stuff. This is kind of like what we want the boat to work, is we want the crap to fall through the tiles and sit down here until we get in, pull the tiles up, and wash it all to one of the pickup ports in the front or back. That way we can have something in here that's muddy and sandy, and you know, that stuff. Somebody said, well, wash it off before you bring it over. And it's like, yeah, we will, but you never get everything. So there'll be a nice workplace down in there that you don't be afraid to get dirty. Let's see. And the guys this morning, man, we put Kressel, he was mucking out those keels yesterday. So they're getting something much nicer to do today as they're working on moving. They got that tandem axle set pulled off the back of the trailer there. And now they're cutting it apart because we only need one axle out of it. The one axle we clean out of it is going to go back underneath this trailer, and that trailer is going to carry the three mast and the pilot house, and then to the port when we get ready to launch. And then that axle underneath there, that tandem axle, sets in good, pretty good shape. One of them's bent, but not badly. They're going to pull it forward, hopefully, out the other end, and that way we'll give us two of them. There's another one already down there. Then they'll put, those will get rolled into place back behind these keels. That's going to help us start thinking about the carriage that will lift the boat up, jack it up, set it back down on that, and that'll be the wheels for the boat for a transportation. Okay. Guess I'm pretty much done with this test tank. I'm going to pull these things out here in the next couple weeks and see how they've all fared. And actually, I think we already know the results. The ones that did good, and the ones that haven't, really haven't. Let's see, this is the one right here that hasn't done good. I can see that chip on the top of it. And we'll take a better look at them later on. I don't want to jump to any conclusions. Basically, I've learned that I just love coal tar. It's a wonderful thing. And Richard Day came by. Oh, this is the day. If you're, especially if you're a local, you can hop in your car and head up to Scotook, Oklahoma, to the Video Woodworkers. I don't know what they call it. They just call it Video Woodworkers. So a festival, a fair, a encampment.
I don't know. If you Google Woodworkers Scotook, you'll find it.
Yeah. Or Video Woodworkers, they'll take you to.
And who's yeah. There and everything.
Yeah, there's they got like, I think
Jimmy
there was.
Jimmy DiResta.
DiResta's there and like.
Nick Ferry's organized a lot of it, I think.
Is that right?
Uh-huh.
And there's a bunch of guys up there that if you love woodworking, it's the place to go today.
James Wright? Woodwright?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've actually heard of that one.
He'll be here tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, James come down here tomorrow because they break up tomorrow. And this is something that, isn't that cool? What did you make today? That's my closing line. You get it early now. This is something Richard Day did for us. Richard has his own YouTube channel. I'll put a link up to that. Where if you want to learn about making signs, he's the guy for that, LEDs and all that stuff on it. And he made this one for us too, which is a stencil. And you can get Richard to make these for you if you want to buy one from him. He'll be happy to sell them. He's way behind now in work because he's got a lot of it. But stolen from SV Seeker is what that one's. So we can stencil that on. And no, nothing's gotten stolen ever here. It's just a joke. And I got to say thank you to Dick. And I think we say it Deck. Dick Deck from Napa, California.
Duck.
I don't think it's Dick Duck.
Could be Dweck.
But I know it was Dick Duck in junior high because, you know, that's just the way junior high kids are. I was Doug the Bug was my mother's thing, but that didn't go over very well. It was Jackson the Jackass in my junior high, which actually fit my personality really well, which is why I'm so harping now today on be nice to people. Don't be an ass, because I have experience there. Look at that. Isn't that a beautiful thing? That is for heating the boat. We'll probably use it up in the forward cabin. Because the aft cabin is so close. I have another one of these that I got off the school bus, but this one's actually in good shape, doesn't leak, and has motors that work. So a beautiful addition to our equipment for the boat. Thank you very much, Dick. Because what you do, you just plumb, it's real simple, you just plumb a hot water line into it from your engine or your solar collector or whatever else is making your hot fluid on the boat and wire it into 12 volts, a couple switches, good to go. This is a donation too. This is Pour 15's fuel tank sealer. I thought this would be a lot like their Pour 15 product that they, it says under that says standard fuel tank sealer. I thought this would be like their Pour 15 product. And I've used that on the samples out there and it's worked good. And they were going to give me some paint for doing the inside of the boat. But instead I'm switching to Rust Doctor. It's a competitor of theirs, but their stuff, to be fair, when you paint on Pour 15, you get the converter and you get a layer of paint over the top of the converter. Rust Doctor is just the converter, so you have to still paint over it. So Pour 15 is kind of a different product, but I did take advantage of their offer to get them to send me some fuel tank sealer. And you normally put this inside a fuel tank and roll it around. But we're just painting it on those seams like you saw us do down there, and it seems to be working dandy for it. And it's nothing like their other stuff. Their other stuff is a little more complicated to put on. It's got to be the right temperature, the right thickness of the coat. Ooh, coffee cake. And the right humidity, which is something we screwed up on. Let me get a piece of this up.
Well, so does that Pour 15 smell?
It doesn't have much of an odor to it at all.
How long does it take to dry?
Not bad. I think it was starting to set up in about 30 minutes. I'm going to cover this up so the flies don't have such a good time with this. You know, if you don't like flies, you just stay out of Oklahoma in the summer. They're here. We've been talking to Doug Fox about bosun's chairs, and he's a climber, and when I was in better shape, used to be a climber too, not to his level of technicality, I think, here. But yeah, he's got ascenders here. And there's videos now that people are really using this stuff to go up their mast more. And hey, maybe we can get him to go up that mast out there in the back tomorrow. That'd be fun to do. We got the wrong kind of lines on it. I don't know if he brought a static line along. But anyway, this is the kind of gear that we'll be using, is, you know, tubers and ascenders and beaners. And I really like being in a seat better too, because I'm afraid I'm going to, you know, drop a tool, grab it, and then be in a bosun's chair and slide right out of the thing.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
Bummer.
Let's talk about safety.
Good God, no!
Oh, yes.
Anything but safety.
Yes, let's talk about safety. Is this thing working? We get any comments, any questions there?
Good morning from Minnesota. Good morning from Ontario. Paul Hatch said the screen is blank on his end. Paul, you can take the sleep mask off.
Yeah. Paul, it's... Oh, I need to go introduce you to Bob out there, too.
And the doodle dog.
And the doodle dog.
The visiting doodle dog.
The labradoodle.
And why you think that dog is stupid?
The labradoodle is stupid because it doesn't do what I say. But it's getting better. So this is Cheryl. Say good morning.
Good morning.
And that's labradoodle. I think her name is... I can't remember. Where'd Bob go?
Maggie.
Yeah, that's the dog's name, yeah.
Maggie.
Yeah. You remember it, huh? Where'd Bob at? He's around?
Somewhere. You can't keep him
still. Yeah, I think there's somebody at the gate. Oh, Bob's doing the gate duty for us. Here, let me you guys are going to have to wait this one out. We got some guests up there.
How you doing?
Oh, you're James.
Dave.
Dave. Yeah, see, I have a James coming tomorrow, too. Yeah, I think tomorrow's going to be kind of a blow-off day for us, because...
So
why don't you come over tomorrow?
Okay.
We can goof around a little bit. We're just not going to take work very seriously, because it's hard when you get new people.
Yep.
Because you don't know where anything is. You don't know... Yeah, so...
I hear you.
So it's great when you come for a weekend.
Well, that means days are harder. Too, because
that's good. We'll call it a recruiting day.
Okay.
So we suck you in to be another sucker. I mean volunteer.
Okay.
And this is a guy you ought to meet too. This is Bob. Bob, you want to give him your handle? You go by your handle more than you do, Bob.
Call me by Okie Chopper.
Okie Chopper.
Yep.
All right.
Robert.
And you have the. His gig now is it a Facebook page?
Yes.
And it's Baby Boomer?
Baby Boomers, 1946 to 1964.
Yeah. So if you guys want to pine all the things that our generation, I didn't know I was a baby boomer, but apparently I'm in that date range, barely. Our generation has lost. It's a good place to go. That's a great generation, though. Maybe this next one will be a fantastic generation, but it's getting off to a pretty damn rocky start, right?
Yeah, we're 770 million strong.
But there's a lot of us. Yeah, so it doesn't matter. Even if you were good, we could outshout you.
Exactly.
Yeah, so that's Bob. Bob's been watching our videos for... How long have you been watching our videos? Too long.
Going on 3 years.
Yeah. And we don't encourage you to watch our videos. Actually, we encourage you to get out and do something in your shop. So if you feel inspired to do that right now, we've succeeded. And goodbye. Okay, I'm back.
Yay. Oh, I so missed you.
Did you?
Yes.
It's that charming personality I have.
So let's get on with this safety stuff.
Yeah, we're going to get past this. Let me see. I got to shoot somewhere so it's not back toward the bright source of light. All right. Safety. Safety is important. You know, it's kind of funny. People think I don't have safety gear or care about safety or take care of the people that are here and all those things. That's just stupid, okay? I love people and I don't want anybody here injured. And it's like, well, you're gonna have that stuff. Look, there is the rack. You walk past this every time. And it's just loaded up with hearing protection and goggles of your choice. And
glove box.
Yeah, and then there's the glove box, which we literally call that.
Yeah, plenty of gloves.
And if you don't like something there, there's another one down below that has aprons and all that kind of crap in it.
We have our lovely welding jackets.
I even have... Where'd they go?
What?
They're in a box up there somewhere.
What?
I used to have, I may not have them anymore, guards for the grinders. If you want to put a guard on your grinder, you actually could put a guard on your grinder. My policy is this. I stated it in the video, but I asked a question the other day of how to better say this, state our policy. And what I got was a lot of people trying to change my policy. Toward that end, go fuck yourself. I'm not going to change my policies. I am what I am, and I hate that. You know, it's like that's part of the deal. That's part of what's pushing me to my new statement.
Your policy is basically people should be responsible for themselves.
Yeah, it's you're responsible for yourself. And there's an argument. There's a wide range of arguments. And I really do appreciate everybody who posted on that, even those of you that I completely disagree with, because it does. It's part of the mindset out there, and it's part of what we're actually working against. You know, my favorite guys on the planet are Shackleton, Joshua Slocum.
You're not going to start asking me who these people are again.
Some of you know who they are. Shackleton's a big one. Yeah, he's the guy.
Darwin.
Darwin, love Darwin. Zoo science on a boat. Everybody said, you got to have this and this and this on the boat to get science done.
Captain Kidd.
Darwin didn't find it. Captain Kidd. People who were adventurous and dangerous and took risk. And we've lost that from a society. And I have in my mind, I tie that to safety because of books I've listened to. And that would be Richard Dawkins, The Selfish Gene. Fantastic book. Now, if you're dyed in the wool Christian that's, you know, evolution is not a thing, don't listen to that book. It'll drive you nuts. Because I used to be on your side of the fence. And then there's another one. Dawkins introduced this idea of the meme, and that word gets used a lot now. I don't think people know what the hell it means. So you got to read the book. And Dawkins is the guy that made the term up. Now everything can change, but you ought to know what he meant when he said it. And then the guy, Richard Brody, wrote a book called Viruses of the Mind, which is a fantastic way of seeing how ideas and concepts like safety and fear and, you know, oh, you ought to do it this way, how those ideas spread through our society. And the two tie together really well because we've got this reptilian brain that says, bring it up to, you know, thousands of years back, we got this brain that was designed of sitting around the campfire telling stories, and you know, it's like, did you see that shit that happened to Og today? You know, I didn't know crocodiles got that big. And those stories, they work for us. And so we have, that has been built into us, and now it's like it's gone to this extreme that when I buy a screwdriver and it has a label on it that says wear eye protection, you know, when using this tool, it's gone just too damn far, you know? And some people say, well, no, you really ought to have eye protection. Good, you know, that's nice. You go do your thing. I'm not gonna tell you what to do. But here's the deal is, you're not gonna tell me what to do. And you're not gonna use my channel to spread that meme. So my new policy is this. If you post, and mostly what I say is, hey, you ought to be doing such and so, you know, because this is dangerous. I normally say, yes, thank you, Mom, we'll be careful. And people get pissed off by that. It's like, it's okay for you to come into my life and tell me what the fuck to do, but it's not okay for me to tell you to, hey, take one. No. So here's the way. You're spreading a meme that I'm on the other side of the fence from, so your comment is going to go away. And if you do it consistently, we got this beautiful button on YouTube. It's great. You click on it, and it means this person can type all they want, and nobody will ever see it, and they won't know. So it's a cool little button, and
can I say something?
I don't mind using it. Yes, you may. And I talk too much.
Well, I do too, but that's why we're just so perfect together.
Yeah, we fight for it.
I finally snarked in yesterday on Facebook because I realized these people had been bantering this subject all freaking day.
I knew it would be a trigger when I put it up, but
do
I didn't expect
that. Do you know what
that
you could have accomplished in that day as opposed to sitting on your ass?
Yeah.
Debating safety issues.
Yeah.
That's pitiful.
Well, it's, and it is. It's because it ties back into that brain of ours. It just says, yeah, this is important.
You know, I have to say, we do have a really good track record for safety. And it's not because of anything we have done physically, other than we try to keep things cleaned up.
I love the minds.
People have got to watch where they're walking. And if you don't feel comfortable doing something, we are not going to push you in that situation.
There's no way I'm going to push anybody to do something they don't want to do.
So, you know, people come, and if they say, well, I really don't know if I want to do that, we go, hey, no
problem.
That's
great. That is a great stance to have. And the reason why you'll get hurt on employers is because employers expect you to do it.
Yeah.
Instead of what employers should do is like, Bob, if you don't want to do this today, we want you to walk away from it. You go back and you help change, change oil in the car or do whatever you can be comfortable with. But if you're not comfortable doing this today, we do not want you doing it.
And you know, and it may be tomorrow you have a totally new outlook. I mean, you know how it is when you drive your car some days and you're driving around and you finally get home and you think, holy shit, I'm not driving anymore today. This is not my day on the road.
Yeah.
Because you just, it's like, geez. Everybody's
well, and you said something the other day too that was this part of it as well. It's where you're viewing this from.
True.
When you're sitting in a chair looking at it, you can find it easy.
And you can nitpick every little thing.
But when you're out there doing it, it's obvious to you that it's not a problem. But on camera, it may look like one. So your mind says, no, this is not a big deal. And it's that part of staying focused on your work. That's when I get injured. I'm thinking about something else. Then I get hurt.
I mean, there's times you get to a point you say, we're done, we're quitting.
Yeah, I'm just too tired.
You know, things aren't going right, and that's when you start to lose your focus, and that's when it all goes down the tubes.
Yes, yeah, it's just knowing when to,
we're really lucky.
Knowing when to step away. Yeah, the only injury we've had is an eye injury. And it was a piece of steel stuck in his eye. It required going to the doctor because I couldn't get it out, he couldn't get it out.
And they used a magnet.
They tried the magnet.
It didn't work.
I have the tool now. Yeah. It's a little fine filament loop, and you just drag it across, and it snagged the splinter and pulled it out.
But he was wearing safety
glasses.
He's
wearing safety glasses and a shield. No. And it probably got put in there when he, took off his, wiped some sweat, and then it probably dropped in with a piece of sweat. There's no telling how it got in.
See, these people didn't see my poison ivy. My God, would they go crazy on that one? You did. Well, you should have worn long sleeves. Don't you know you're supposed to wear long sleeves? If I'm working in the yard, I'm going to try and get some color, okay? I am willing to take that risk. The stupid thing I did was I attacked a pile of brush with a weed.
Yeah.
And it just sent that stuff flying.
Yeah, I've done it with a chainsaw. Yeah.
So, he was harping on me. You should have worn long sleeves. You should have worn pants.
Yeah.
Didn't you take a shower right away? So
nice
he can be that
it.
Way. I know, but it's just it's where you're sitting.
It's where you're sitting. It is.
And
it is
if you were out there doing what I was doing, you'd have done the same thing, probably.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
So it's just a point of view.
It's a point of view. So anyway, some of you are dicks, okay? Let's just face it. But most of you aren't. Most of you are great people, and you're sincere about the safety thing, and I appreciate that. I mean, that touches me, and I feel the love. Thank you very much. I love you back. But it's the, we need to think about the motivation behind it. Why is it that is in our lexicon of societal things it's okay to do? It's okay to tell somebody, you need to do this. And in my book, but not here. This is not the place for that, and this channel is not the place for that, so those comments are going to go away. And you ask, well, you can't tell. Yeah, I can. It's my channel. I can do what I want. I'm not really interested about viewerships or subscriberships. I'm interested in developing a good, tight, supportive group of people. That's what I'm looking for on this channel. I'm not looking to cross that 100,000 subscriber mark. If I never do, fine. I'd rather have 12 good people than 1,200...
I lost my train of thought. It's a voluntary process.
Let's talk to I'm going to talk to Kressel and.
Well, I would certainly get them to leave over there because the ship will screw your signal up.
Let me try and get close. I want to see what they're doing.
Stand in the back of the rudder.
Oh,
go back there.
Yeah, that's fairly unblocked. Okay. Where'd that new guy go? Is he up on the boat? Oh, he's watching them. Well, I hear banging.
And the train's coming by this morning.
Come here. Let me tell him what to do for a little bit. I want you to tell him what to do. It's a little over my head, but I love it anyway. You mind talking on camera a bit? Yeah, okay. Good. This is Doug Fox. There you stand right there. Camera's right there. It's out of the wind. Can you see it?
Yeah. All
right. This is Doug Fox. Doug, you can talk all about this, right? Who do you work for? You work for some, what do they work for? You work for some company that works for the power plant, right?
No, I work directly for the company that owns it.
Oh, do you? What company is that?
That's NextEra Energy.
And who do you supply power for?
Large chunk of Iowa.
Large chunk of Iowa? And which plant is it up there?
That's Duane Arnold.
It's what?
Duane Arnold.
Duane Arnold, that's the name of the plant?
Yep. And it's named after a local guy. One of the big towns.
How long is that? And it's a nuclear facility?
Yep.
And how many megawatts can you put out? How big is it on the size of nuclear facilities?
It's kind of small for nuclear facilities.
It's small. Iowa, it's in the...
Cool.
You don't think about a dense population.
We're the second largest population in the state. Cedar Rapids.
Okay, Cedar Rapids is who it supplies.
Yeah. So it's mostly Cedar Rapids local industry.
Yeah.
And we send a little bit of power up to other places for higher voltage.
So I just wanted to point out that some people say, "What? You ever have engineers look at the boat?" And it's like, I do happen to have engineers look at the boat. So yeah, it's great to have people like this come in. And you're going back for a master's or?
That's the goal, it's a master's. I'm thinking systems engineering. I've got a little bit of time to decide that.
Right. So you're taking classes, and then you got to finally pick one that...
Yeah, before I start taking classes that don't count.
Yeah, yeah. Because that's always... You don't ever want to do that. I never want to do that. It's more important for me, I think, than it is for you.
Yeah,
you probably have a few that don't count.
Yeah, I got a few, but I like to do it.
Yeah.
I wanted to entertain and take classes.
What is it about working here? Why do you come here and do this? Because this is your second time here.
I like large projects. I like your dream and getting this thing going.
So it's the idea behind it, the dream, the basis of it.
Because I haven't figured out what big thing I want to do, so I've got small projects in it all the time.
Is it going to have a nuclear reactor on it when you do?
Probably not.
Probably not.
With all the regulations, it would be too.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks for your time. Appreciate you being here.
All right. Let's go up. Well, you know what? I'm just going to talk a little bit about Crestle, and I'm going to wrap up because I want to get to work because it's not going to get anything but hotter today. Hey, Crestle, you up there?
He's giving a tour.
Yeah, I know, but he can hear me.
What's that?
Hey. What's up? You're going to be on video later on. I'm going to put you on the real gig that goes out next week. Okay?
Okay.
All right, so keep on giving your tour.
I think we're pretty much done.
All right, you want to come down here and talk then?
Sure.
Cool, come on. Sit him up right beside the Wi-Fi. Can't get any better connection than that. Let's shoot back into the building, though. You want to stand in the sun or in the shade?
Probably. Here's good. We got a nice offset light.
There you go. See, he does videos. And the nice thing about Crestle here is he does... this is his channel. You know, it's maker size on YouTube as well.
Yeah.
It's spectacular. I know. I'm wearing a big Brutus t-shirt, so... He's got a great channel. The thing I love about his channel is, he is the only guy that's come by here that I've actually watched his videos before he ever contacted me. Because of that, it's just that from nothing start, And it's like the boat is from nothing, It's like, why didn't you buy a boat? I get that question. It's like, why didn't you buy this? Why didn't you buy that? It's like, that's not the point. This guy so totally knows that. He's got a beautiful channel. It's not like mine. It's G-rated. It's nice. It's calm. He doesn't ever insult anybody. It's like completely different than what I do. He cares about you. The weird thing is, he's been doing it for 2 years now, and you're up like 40,000 subscribers.
15.
15.
15.
15.
Yeah.
I thought you were 40. He needs more. Needs more subscribers because the quality of work he does. I watched DeRista and the other guys too. and his quality is excellent. And his videography is good. His presentation's good. He thinks it out. He's an engineer in mind back behind it. He built this lathe from nothing. I mean, he's casting, doing a lot of casting. And it's the kind of casting that I really like because it's not my kind of casting. My kind of casting is getting... You don't go out and start doing what I'm doing, you know, because this is done for the size of the boat. His casting is something that 90% of what I cast is easily done in your size furnaces. So they're smaller furnaces, they're home projects. He built a lathe from scratch, so you learn all about this lathe. Now you're working on a shaper. You have your shaper piece?
I do.
Let's put it in the other video. So we're going to put it in the real video that comes out, not the live stuff. We'll show us the shaper that he's working on now. But it's an excellent channel. I highly recommend it. Stop watching my videos. Go watch his, okay? It'll be so much better for you. And it'll piss you off. Your heart rate will be down. It'll be good. You don't have to worry about safety. He's a very safe person. In fact, he made me do the fucking painting inside the other day. He says, what's the Buick's deal on this? I said, I don't know, but it's probably pretty bad. So he split and started working on the axles out there. And so, yeah.
Which, I did get some on my hand.
Oh, God. I've been scratching it off my arm all morning long. And last night, I was at dinner. I'm doing this, you know. The waitress probably thinks I got leprosy or something. I'm piling up the shavings of paint on the deck. Anyway. That's a beautiful thing. You want to say anything about your channel?
Not really.
I covered it pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I do want to say something, which is this is way cooler in person than watching. So if anybody hasn't come out here, don't wait too long.
Yeah.
It'll be in the water. You won't have the opportunity.
Well, you can still come out when we're in the water. It's just you're going to have to get on an airplane to come find us.
But at any rate, you got to come check it out. Yeah. I mean, even if you just do the Saturday tour, come see it.
Yeah, and Bart's not here to give tours today, so you ended up giving a tour. Thank you very much.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. Did you recruit him? Will he be back next week to work?
I don't know. I'll twist his arm a little harder.
Yeah, all right,
hey,
good.
Hey, how was the thing last night? How were those people?
Yeah, you went up and drank some beers with the guys that...
Yeah, we went up and...
Did you crawl under the fence?
It was dummy locked, so we did have to disable.
Breaking and entering is not a thing in Oklahoma. It's cool.
It was just a big cow pasture. Like I thought the guys were messing with me because we just kept driving in the middle of nowhere. I thought they're just sending me on a wild goose chase. And
did you hear banjo music?
Maybe it's in the back of my head, but there was some playing. Yeah. No, it's actually Waylon Jennings, I think, playing. But we got out there. We could see some lights out in the distance, and we got out there and. Sure enough, here, you know, they've got a lathe set up, turning, you know, a bunch of guys standing
around. In the
middle
of the night. You got there, what, 10:30?
10:30 or 11, because vehicle overheated, we had to wait for it to cool down, got on the road. Anyway, it's all good, it was a lot of fun.
You need to fix your fan today on that thing, don't you?
I do, I need to get a replacement radiator cooling fan, because when it's sitting still,
it overheats. You need to take care of that, yeah.
But when I'm on the road, as long as I don't stop in traffic, it'll be fine.
It'll be all right, yeah.
Or I turn the engine off on the
traffic light. Oh, there's no wireless just down the street.
Yeah, I need to do that. I'll probably do that tomorrow. But.
Okay, all right.
So are they coming by tomorrow?
I think there's probably at least a handful of folks coming by tomorrow.
Okay.
Is that a hand of five? Is this like a hand of six, like that?
I would say...
The man with six fingers.
You know, if I were guesstimating, I would say probably on one hand.
All right,
one
cool.
Normal.
Yeah, we're pretty much counting up to tomorrow. It's just a blow-off day. We'll get a little work done. But for now, we're going to wrap this up and we're going to get some work done.
Question.
Oh, what is it?
Brian wanted to know of your paint samples, you know, in the tub over there. Did you weigh them beforehand?
Weigh them?
I'm surprised I guess they all weigh the same. I mean, to know if they...
Oh, looking for anything, is it blading? I don't know why you'd weigh it.
Did you lose any material during the process? I mean, it was quite... I mean, Brian... Listen, the guy that did this with Doug is
he was a chemical engineer.
Hoped to be in his lifetime.
Oh my God, yeah, he was. Can't think of his name right
charts.
Now.
Charts.
Yeah, we have a spreadsheet that tells us what each sample is based on a binary code that's drilled into the samples. I don't think we've lost any. I don't think that's an issue. You do lose volume to paint as it cures because you breathe in that stuff that comes off the paint, but I don't think you. If it was, what we're looking at is we're going to take a box knife, is what I'm going to do once all the samples come out. I'm going to run that box knife across them again, and that's just to make sure that the paint still, it didn't turn brittle, because that's one of the bad things. If you get a brittle paint, then when you get it bumped, you know, a chip comes off, so that'll be the only real test I do. And I'm going to look to see, and I damaged all the samples before they went into the tank, so we can see how much the rust progressed underneath the paint, because that means it doesn't have a good adhesion, and it doesn't... you know, it's not stopping that progression of rust, so we'll look for those type things. But that's pretty much it. And I'm sold on I like Pour 15's product, even though I'm not going to use it. And I liked I definitely like the Rust Doctor, and I like Coal Tar over that. And the other solutions, we're really just putting them together in various combinations to make sure that none of the chemicals have an interaction with each other. And I haven't noticed anything, but we'll give them one last test with a knife and make sure. That's all there is to it. Any more than that, you need a laboratory to do testing. You don't need to be on a tank out on my porch in salt water. You know, it gets boiled every once an hour, so that's just not that kind of testing. So,
okay.
All right, we're good. We're done.
What do you say?
Y'all got to go out and build. What's your test? You have a line that you sign off on?
Yeah. Exercise your inner maker.
Hey, exercise your inner maker today. See you guys. I like that one, but I might steal that.
No.
Well, I gotta get you a t-shirt, then you can...